questions. Thank you, sir. Again, we move to next speaker. Now we have some speeches from our students and universities. Next speaker is Mr. Muhammad Asif. He will be talking about modeling of reference evapotranspiration ET using multiple linear regression approach. So he is from Zakaria University. If he is available, Mr. Muhammad Asif. Asif, we cannot hear you. If you can speak loudly. Yes, now we can listen. Now we can listen to you. Okay, please go ahead. And you have a time span of 10 minutes. Please try to conclude in 10 minutes.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes, very much.
Okay. Today my topic is modeling of reference evapotranspiration using multiple linear regression ML approach. Modeling of reference evapotranspiration using multiple linear regression MLR approach. And my author is Muhammad Asif Azanam Abdulhan and Kaisar Abbas and Rabia Noor. And I am the Abdulhanna. And I am here to starting the presentation. First of all, I have to present the introduction that is about reference evapotranspiration. What is reference? Reference that the evapotranspiration according to any reference point. We calculate the evapotranspiration according to any reference point, and then we can compare those of them. Evapotranspiration is the estimation of evapotranspiration from a reference body. It is a combination of two separate processes. Evaporation, that is loss of water from the soil surface or any other open body. And the other one is transpiration. What is transpiration? Transpiration is the removal of water from the plant surface. That pic shows both of evapotranspiration. One is evaporation and other is the transpiration. And the combination of transpiration and the evaporation is called the evapotranspiration. And then I am going to there's a case study that is held in the district Multan, provinces Punjab, Pakistan. Pakistan's seventh largest city. That area is about 290 kilometers square, fertile land and covered with the plant and trees. There are four tehsils like Shujabad, Jalalpur, Khanawal. Other one, the objective of my study is the proposed research aims to be developed a multiple linear regression model with the help of sustainable software Minitab by using five input climate parameters to estimate the ET node. ET node means the reference evapotranspiration. To develop, and the second objective of my this study is to develop a multiple linear regression model in the form of an equation. I will show you the equation that I have developed in this study. And the third objective of my study is the predicting the reference evapotranspiration values with the help of that equation that I have developed in this study. Methodology that I have used in this study, that is multiple linear regression MLR approach. It is a statistical technique that is used to predict the output values of a variable depending on two or more variables. It is an advanced form of linear regression, partial correlation of the multiple inputs. In this study, mini linear regression, we have inputs more than one, and in my study, there are the five inputs, and we have the one output that is the 18 hour evapotranspiration according to any reference point. Multiple linear regression approach. Predict variable is known as the dependent variable, and the other variables used to predict the dependent variable are known as the explanatory or independent variables. If you see that equation, y is the independent variable, y is the dependent variable, whereas the x1, x2, x3, and xn are all the dependent variable, independent variables. We have divided our all data into two parts. One is used for training, and other used for calibration or testing, or the with five input parameters such as a mean, minimum, and maximum temperature, one. And second one is the relative humidity, and third one the sunshine oil, and fourth one the wind speed. Two are minimum and maximum temperatures are two parameters. The multiple linear regression equation is as follows. This equation is the multiple linear regression equation, where y is the output or predicted value of the dependent variable x1, and up to so on xn are the independent variable or predictors. B node and B1 are the regression coefficient of the developed equation. Results. developer of MLR model, multiple linear regression is good potential to predict the dependent variable with the help of independent variables along with show a non-linear relationship. Simulated the data for calibration with the help of statistical software of 66 years data of study area. After the simulation, MLR developed an equation of 5 inputs based on the data. This equation is developed by in my study. ET node is equal to -164.7 plus this one is a constant and other one is 0.0114 T. Minimum temperature and other one is the maximum temperature, and this is the relative humidity, and that value is in wind speed, and that is 13.81 is the sunshine hour, where every T maximum, every T minimum is used in degrees, every relative humidity. This one is in percentage, wind speed in meter per second, and sunshine hours are used in the hours. This equation is developed by in my model MLR, that is my results in conclusions I will discuss. Development of MLR model. This results are conducted from the my training model. The contour maps are plotted between the every two parameters which showed the trend of ET node. Definitely transpiration. Every contour shows the different ET node value by color representation. If you see that that picture, the color shows the ET node values. That graphs are of the two parameters. Like this one is the minimum temperature, and that one is the maximum temperature. That one is the surface temperature and the relative humidity. And there on the right side, we can see the ET node values by seeing the color, and we can calculate the ET node and we can estimate the value. Third contour plotted between wind speed and minimum temperature. Third contour have four colors shows different ET node values at distinct value of the both input parameters. They can be vary by the parameters. Validation of MLR model. These results are the conducted from the equation that I have developed in my model. Developed MLR model based equation predict the future results by putting the input values in the equation. In that equation, we can put the values of minimum temperature, maximum temperature, relative humidity, wind and sunshine are according to the our environment and according to the place to place. We can calculate the ET node values. And the developed equations predict the next 5 years results of ET node. That equation equation give us the results of the next 5 years. The result of next 5 years is quite satisfactory shown in the figure. Every contour have different colors shows different estimation of ET node values at the existing value of input parameters. Now I have discussed the conclusions. Reference upper transpiration is an important parameter in the field of hydrology and the water resources. This study used to develop a model by using 66 years small with 5 input climatic data of the study area. For the developing equation, the multiple linear regression model was used to predict the equation based on the provided data. Furthermore, by using this developed equation to predict the values of ET node for the next 5 years and plotted the contours of predicted ET node with the input parameters. The contour shown a good relationship of every input parameter for estimation and good results of ET node compared to the previous contour data. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hannan from Bahauddin Zakaria University, and thanks for concluding your presentation.